Good morning, HR team. First of all, wish you, your family and everyone there a very, very happy new year. Divya and I were planning to send this video on 30th or 31st. Then we realized that our WhatsApp group will be completely flooded with new year messages. So we thought we need to be more patient, and hence we are sending this video today. I'm going to take a couple of minutes to kind of share with you how this year has been for us in HR, in GAVL, and you know what's lying in store for 2020. So, you know, when I reflected on that and when I kind of went back in 2019, the year kind of started with two important things. One is we had the Aon Hewitt Employee Engagement Survey, through which we got very, very good feedback from each one of you on what's working and what are the areas that we need to work on, right? So that was one input. We also started working on our HR agenda for FY20. I think these were the two things we started the year with. I must say that on the HR agenda, we have made really good progress in last 2 years with all the efforts and involvement of each one of you. We are working on four pillars, like I keep explaining to you all the time. The first one is, how do we help the businesses become sustainable and profitable? The second one is, how do we build talent sufficiency in each of our businesses? The third one is, how do we make GAVL and each of the BUs as an inspiring workplace? And the fourth one is, to achieve all that, how do we build one capable GAVL HR team, right? So on each of these pillars, we have taken various initiatives. We have made really good progress on those initiatives. And I would like to thank and compliment all of you for making that possible, right? In a separate note, I'm going to share with you what is going to be our FY21 agenda. That is still kind of a work in progress. Next week, I'm going to present that to Balram and then to the larger leadership team. So sometime in March or so, I think, you know, I will communicate to you what has been, what is the, you know, the agenda going forward for FY21. Now, let me come to the pillar that is very, very close to my heart, which is one capable HR. And in that, I think when we look back, 2019 was the year of many firsts. There were many things that we did for the first time. When we looked at the feedback that you had given, I think three themes stood out. The one is learning, the second one is careers, and the third one is recognition. So basically you said that, how do I, in Godrej, how do I become a better HR professional? The second was, how do I grow my career in Godrej? And the third one is, we do all the work, we kind of institute recognition mechanisms for others. How do we get recognized for good work that we do in the business? So I think these are the three themes we started with, and I'm really happy that, you know, we have made some headway as leadership team on that. I think for the first time in our business, we had what is called as HR bootcamp. Many of you from different businesses came together. I think 31 of you were there, where the bootcamp actually helped you get into the details of HR processes, HR policies, HR labor laws, right? And you also underwent a session on selector capability. I hope this was very useful to you. We plan to run one more session for people who couldn't attend last time, and that will happen in 2020. We also did some fun quiz with all of you for the labor codes that are kind of getting formulated. We did one on the wage code bill, where you know, we tried to study all of us and said, you know, what are the changes that are happening. So there is more and more learning that is going to come our way, and you know, I always say that we should stay hungry for everything that is coming our way through learning. The second first was, is the HR conference that we had exclusively for the first time for our entire GAVL HR team. We kind of took two days out for all of us to reflect on what is the business vision. So Balram kind of spent time with us. What's happening in the GILAC HR? We also tried to discuss what is the HR agenda for GAVL. And we had invited the leaders from the business, helping us understand what their expectations from HR are and how they are experiencing the work that is happening in HR. We also, in the second part of the conference, understood and discussed what HR careers are all about and what does it take to build your career in Godrej. We looked at, if you remember, three kind of buckets in which HR careers rest. One is COEs, second is HRBPs, and third is HR operations or shared services. And each one of them bring a different kind of value. So I'm not going to get into it because most of you were there. But one principle that stood out is if you want to really make your career grow, you'll have to take risks. You'll have to get out of your comfort zone and, be open to take different roles in the business. And I'm very happy that some of you have implemented that principle, have taken bold decisions of moving across the different roles. So, for example, Priyanka was doing, sales HR in Pune in crop protection. Now she moved to CDPL and she's handling talent acquisition. Divya was handling diversity and inclusion and engagement here in Godrej One. Now she's handling talent acquisition. Jyoti actually said, I want to explore the wider canvas in GILAC. So, from the L&D role in GAVL, now he's doing the HR business partnering role with properties. Omkar said, enough of candidates in talent acquisition. So he's moved to Mahad. And I'm sure all the union leaders there are keeping him on his toes. And that's what, he's been telling me whenever I meet him. But I'm very, very happy that, some of you have taken that step of testing yourself, challenging yourself. I think that's the way to grow. The third theme that, came out in the survey was about recognition. So we have kind of, as a leadership team, instituted a very customized recognition platform for GAVL HR, which is called GAVL HR Awards. We had one set of awards, that were given in the conference, and many more would follow. And I think the one thing that I want to tell you is you just keep focusing on doing good work, and rest you leave it to us in terms of recognition and your career growth. So with all this good work happening, I think now 1 year is over. One thing I want to tell you is, so while it's just a change of calendar, it's also a good opportunity for us to reflect individually. So one thing you can do is really sit back and ask two questions to yourself. One is, what are the lessons that you have learned in 2019? And the second question is, how do you plan to leverage opportunities that will come your way in 2020? And if you spend some time reflecting on that, I think you are in a better position to really walk into 2020, right? We have a Cricket World Cup, 2020 World Cup coming up in later during the year, and everybody watching this video are nodding their head. And if I use that analogy, guys, this is the year for us to bat on our front foot and also at the same time enjoy this entire game. So thank you so much for being with us in 2019, and let's get ready for all the excitement in 2020. Bye-bye.